السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله حمدا طيبا طاهرا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى، حمدا ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء من شيء بعد. أحق ما قال العبد، وكلنا لك عبد، لا راد لما قضيت ولا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت، ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Yesterday we reached to the verse when Allah تبارك وتعالى says about the people of Kaif, قال الذين غلبوا على أمرهم لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا. People, when they found those youth 300 years ago, they escaped to protect themselves from converting to disbelief, to stay in the right direction. And Allah make them as miracle for all of us, as proof also that Allah tabarak ta'ala will resurrect us, inshallah, in the day of Qiyam. Proof that Allah brought them to life again, as Allah will bring us to life also. Even, doesn't matter, 300, 3,000, 3 million, you will be back. You will be back again. Then Allah says that the people in their time, they said, لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا. لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا. Some people they said, what is wrong if we found some people now died and their قبر, their grave in the masjid and the people praying? That's Allah says, لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا. So it means nothing wrong. Said al-Badawi, مش عارف ايه, الحسين, الصو. So what is wrong with that? Yet it is wrong. Number one, it is wrong to put the grave and pray to the grave anywhere. It is wrong. Number one, because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that. He said, لا تتخذوا قبري بعدي وثنا يعبد. Don't worship me in my grave after my death. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that. Somebody will ask, but why the grave of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-Masjid Nabawi? There. In al-Masjid al-Nabawi there. So also that it was not in al-Masjid al-Nabawi. But when they extend al-Masjid al-Nabawi, they try to avoid, make the grave in the Qibla, but they tried their best, but the Masjid has to be bigger. So millions of people now. So it was based on the extension, it is in the corner there, but is not before established the grave, but they cannot move the grave. They can't move the grave. So that's why even the scholars, they said, if you enter any masjid and the grave of any wali, or as the people think, in the front of the imam, it's not allowed. It's not allowed. So anyway, come back to tafsir, just little piece of fiqh. So, قال الذين غلبوا على أمرهم لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا. أي means, let us build by the entrance of the cave, not on their grave, but by the entrance of the cave, by this area, let us build a mosque to let the people remember. And they wrote the names on Al-Raqim. They wrote, but the people of book after, that's a long time ago, the people of book, the Jews, they started to say, how many? Because after time, the names gone and everything gone. They said, how many they were? They started to argue. سيقولون ثلاثة رابعهم كلبهم. Some of the group of the Jews, the people of book, they said, oh, they were three. And the fourth one is the dog. Some of them, they said, ويقولون خمسة سادسهم كلبهم. They said five, but the sixth one is the dog. ويقولون سبعة وثامنهم كلبهم قل ربي أعلم بعدتهم. They said سبعة قل ربي أعلم بعدد ما يعلمهم إلا قليل. So few people they know the exact number. And عبد الله بن عباس said أنا من القليل. He said I am from the few people they know the truth. عبد الله بن yes I am. الحمد لله. والراسخون في العلم. He said I am from them. I am one of the قليل. The few people they know the truth. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم did dua for him. He said اللهم علمه القرآن. اللهم علمه القرآن، اللهم فقهه في الدين وعلمه التأويل. التأويل يعني التفسير. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did this dua for Abdullah ibn Abbas. They said but Abdullah ibn Abbas yes يعني just your opinion like that or you have دليل. He said I have دليل. I have دليل. He said what's the دليل? He said when Allah تبارك وتعالى said 3 or 5 he said after that رجما بالغيب. But when he said 7, he did not say Rajman Bilghay. They were 7. So Abdullah ibn Abbas is the one also. He talk about Laylat al-Qadr. They said to him, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he decided to tell us Laylat al-Qadr. But he did not confirm exact what night. Then he said, try your best in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, or in the last 7 nights of Ramadan, or in the last odd numbers. In the last 10 nights of Ramadan. But what's your opinion as you are from Al-Qalil, Rasikh, Alim? He said, Wallahi, based on my opinion, I think it is the night of 27. They said, based on what? He said, I looked to everything Allah created. I found the heavens 7, the earth 7, even the stages of the creation of the human being 7. لقد خلقنا الإنسان من سلالة من طين ثم جعلناه نطفة في قرار مكين ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة فخلقنا العلقة مضغة فخلقنا المضغة عظاما فكسونا العظام لحمة ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر. The stage of the human being in their mothers 7 stages. And I looked to the food we eat. I found it 7. All types of food 7. ثم شققنا الأرض شقة فأنبتنا فيها حبة وعنبا وقضبا وزيتونا ونخلا وحدائق غلبا وفاكهة وأبا 7. And he said, he mentioned many 7s. It's not need the time to count how many. But he said, and I looked to سورة القدر. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر. I found the سورة is 30 words. 30 words, like the number of the days of the month of Ramadan. 30 words. And the word هي number 27. سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. That's number 27. I said I think 27. That's how the scholars. The scholars they don't say something based on randomly like us. No. They know what they say. Then Allah تبارك وتعالى says قل ربي أعلم بعدتهم ما يعلمهم إلا قليل فلا تمار فيهم. So Allah, even if Abdullah ibn Abbas did that, but Allah telling us, guiding us, don't argue if there is no benefit from the number. Well, Allah told his Prophet Muhammad, فلا تماري فيهم إلا مراء ظاهرة. If you have دليل, confirmation from Allah, خلاص. But otherwise, pass it. Don't stop, but just point long time. فلا تمار فيهم إلا مراء ظاهرة ولا تستفت فيهم منهم أحد. Even don't ask the Jews. They were how many? How many the people of Kif? Don't ask them. ولا تستفت فيهم منهم أحد. There is no action based on the number. The action based on the miracle itself, not the number. Then Allah says, ولا تقولن لشيء إني فاعل ذلك غدا إلا أن يشاء الله. Don't say I'll do something tomorrow except by the will of Allah. If you want to, إن شاء الله, I'll marry فاطمة. ماشي إلياس؟ إن شاء الله. Or محمد بلس. Who is not married yet here? صديق؟ There. So don't say إن شاء الله I'll marry so and so except by the will of Allah. Say inshallah. Don't say inshallah I'll finish the Quran in Ramadan without inshallah. don't say inshallah I'll donate big portion of my income in Ramadan. Say inshallah. ولا تقولن لشيء. But why this verse came here after the story of the people of Kif? Why? I mentioned yesterday that the Jews, they used to pass the questions to the disbelievers in Mecca to ask Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. Then they stopped them. One day Prophet Muhammad ﷺ passed and they stopped them. They said, tell us, if you are a prophet, tell us about the people of Kif, youth, they left their city and they escaped and no one knows about them. Do you have any information about that? Then Prophet Muhammad ﷺ based in Jibreel coming oftenly to him and he said tomorrow, I'll tell you tomorrow. And the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he forgot to say inshallah. See, Prophet Muhammad ﷺ did not say inshallah, he said tomorrow. Based on Jibreel will come and he will ask him what's the story. Jibreel will tell him. But he did not say inshallah. Even Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, yes. Then he wait for Jibreel, tomorrow doesn't come. After tomorrow doesn't come, week, 2 weeks, 15 days. Then they ask him, what is the answer? What is the answer? You are a prophet, what is the answer? Oh. Then Jibreel came after 15 days telling him, revealed this verse, وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْءٍ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ ذَلِكَ غَدًا إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ إِذَا نَسِيتْ. And the scholars said, what وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ إِذَا نَسِيتْ. Also, another issue is inshaAllah. Say, for example, you told الحق محمد, inshaAllah, I'll drive you tomorrow to work. But you forgot to say inshaAllah. I'll drive you tomorrow. Then after 2-3 hours, you remembered. When I told Al-Hajj Muhammad, I did not say inshallah. After 3-4 hours, say inshallah. Say again. Even if you forgot in the beginning. See, the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he prayed two rak'ah after Asr. The Sahaba, they asked him, why you pray just two rak'ah after Asr? He said, this is the sunnah of Dhuhr. I forgot to pray it after Dhuhr. So I make it up after Asr. Oh, even the sunnah. Oh. Even if you, if in the beginning of the food, when you eat, so what is the dua? In the beginning of the food. Huh? Bismillah. Allahumma barik lana fima razaqtana wa qina azab al-nar. What if you forgot, hungry, Ramadan, and stuck in the food right away. Then in the middle of the food, you remember, I did not say Bismillah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sitting with the Sahaba. And he noticed that some of them, they started eating without basmala. Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he looked to them and he said, من نسي أن يقول في أول الطعام بسم الله. If someone he forgot in the beginning to say بسم الله, then he remembered in the middle, فليقل, still, make it up. فليقل بسم الله أوله وآخره. بسم الله أوله وآخره. Even. لا بسم الله خلينا معلش. مش الحديث بتاع الحديث اللي النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام يعلم الصبي وبيعلم الصبي قال له يا غلام سمي الله مش كده؟ ولا قال له احمد الله؟ سمي الله خلاص. حمد الله بعد النعمة. حمد الله بعد الأكل. بعد أن تنتهي. إن الله يحب من عبده إذا أكل الأكلة أن يحمده وإذا شرب الشربة أن يحمده. بعد الانتهاء من الطعام, if you finish your food, finish your drink, then say الحمد لله. So ولا تقولن لشيء إني فاعل ذلك غدا إلا أن يشاء الله واذكر ربك إذا نسيت وقل عسى أن يهديني ربي لأقرب من هذا رشدا. سبحان الله. So imagine الهداية levels. And سبحان الله, there is no limit for هداية. No limit. الهداية levels. سبحان الله. Some people they said, inshallah, والله I wish that my son praying 5 times a day. Then الحمد لله, your son started slowly, but now الحمد لله praying 5 times a day. That's enough? No, I need him. So because when he pray, he look to the watch. So I need him with khushu'. To pray with khushu'. Then I need him to do qiyam al-layl. I need him to know how to read Quran properly. I need, that's it, al-hidayah levels. And subhanallah, on the top of the levels, that's al-rashad. Al-rashad. Subhanallah. قُلْ إِنِّي لَا أَمْلِكُ لَكُمْ ضَرًّا وَلَا رَشَدًا وَلَا رَشَدًا رَشَد سبحان الله الرشد that's نعمة كبيرة is not only the action itself not only the جوارح the organs no الرشد in the قلب in the heart فإن آنستم منهم رشدا الرشد ها لك فلان بلغ سن الرشد Not how big his muscles or so. Maybe muscles, but he's idiot. So, but subhanallah, وَقُلْ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَهْدِيَنِ رَبِّي لِأَقْرَبَ مِنْ هَذَا رَشَدًا May Allah tabarak ta'ala give ilm, give me ilm. But this ilm is not only to argue, no, to act. To practice rashad. To practice rashad. And even when you ask a question, ask the question you need in your life. Not to ask to test the sheikh or the scholar or whatever. No, don't do that. But ask what you need. And ask to practice. Not ask to go to be proud. I want to put my friends down. I know something they don't know. Seek knowledge to practice. وَقُلْ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَهْدِيَنِ رَبِّي لِأَقْرَبَ مِنْ هَذَا رَشَدًا Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in the beginning of the story, he gave something collectively with no details. Then in the end of the story, he gave details. In the beginning of the story, he said, فَضَرَبْنَا عَلَىٰ آذَانِهِمْ فِي الْكَافِ سِنِينَ عَدَدَ Number of years. How many years? A lot. But how many? Then In the end of the story, Allah mentioned details. How many years exactly? Because no one knows. Imagine, maybe that we mentioned that many times. If you slept, if I slept, if anyone is sleeping, wallahi, challenge. I challenge all of you. I challenge myself. If you sleep and you wake up without looking to the watch and this, guess how many hours you slept. The people in the cave, they enter the cave in the early morning. When Allah resurrected them, it was before Maghrib. And some of them, they looked, they expected sunset. It was not set yet. But they expected sunset. They said, لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا We slept all day. But some of them, they said, oh, no, the sun is still not set yet. أو بعض يوم they said not all day little less part of the day it's not all day but Allah says they can't confirm more than that they can't not them us that's why the sleep is الموتة الصغرى this is a small death is this death yes but subhanallah listen to this point You cannot see. If you're sleeping, you don't see, right? You don't see. You don't what? You don't speak. But the only jariha, the only organ, we prayed Asr already. If you want to pray, just pray. We prayed already. The only jariha still working, if you sleep what? Ears, still. If you slept and you don't hear and blocked, then If the house burning or the alarm, if you forgot something on the stove and the alarm working, how you can wake up? If you adjust the alarm to come to the masjid before Fajr, how you can wake up? So see, that's a lot of things. Wallahi, if we are as a human being, think about the power of Allah, we'll humble ourselves. We said, Ya Rabb. Ya Rabb, wallahi, we are without your help, without your support, without your guidance, without your ni'am, what we can do? What? What? So Allah says here the details. وَلَبِثُوا فِي كَهْفِهِمْ. Even if some people argue about the number of them, 3, 5, 7, but no one knows about how many years. Then the answer should come only from Allah. And the accurate answer is not any answer. If Allah mentions the answer, it is the answer, the right one. وَلَبِثُوا فِي كَهْفِهِمْ 300 سِنِينَ. Oh, 300 سِنِينَ. That's based on its calculation now. They said here, Adhan al-Fajr, 555. Based on what? They said North America calendar. Oh, if you change it to Umm al-Qura, you will find it 537. أم القرى. If you put it in the calendar of Karachi, you will find it 539. If you put it on Egyptian, you will find 534. So then, if we count how many years they slept, based on which calendar, which one? Solar calendar, which is known also long time, or lunar calendar, which is also known long time, but the name of the month or so, or the sacred month mentioned in the Quran. إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم. Allah is teaching us the calendars. Allah is teaching us in this verse. ولبثوا في كهفهم 300 سنين. Oh, 300 سنين. The sentence completed now. Then another sentence. This 300 years based on the solar calendar. If you calculate based on the lunar calendar, add 9 more years. It means what? Each 100 years of solar calendar, it is 103 from the lunar calendar. That's simply, I still remember my father, may Allah bless him in Jannah, Ya Rabbi, and my mother, and all the relatives passed away. So I still remember him. He told me, do you know, Ramadan sometimes comes in the hot weather in Egypt, very hot weather. And not only hot weather, but the hot weather was hard work in the farm. Very hard work. It is tough season. But he told me, still remember, he said Ramadan will come in the same season every 33 years. Every 33 years will come in the same season. The same. If came in January, after 33 years will come in January. We are in March. Now, after 33 years, the new generation, not us. We cannot stay 33 years. So, after 33 years, we'll be in March again. But subhanAllah, see, it is the subhanAllah, the people, the humble people, they know the calculation help them to know when Ramadan will come, when Sha'ban, when Hajj will come. And this is also ni'mah from Allah. Why not the same? It is lunar calendar like the solar calendar. Why not? There is any benefit? Huh? Any? Tell us what is the benefit. Huh. What is the benefit to have solar calendar different than lunar calendar? Huh. Sheikh Badr, he will hug him. That's good. That's the hikmah. That's one of the hikmah. That's Ramadan, not only Hajj, Ramadan, Hajj. And subhanAllah, imagine if we are here and always Ramadan comes in July. Always in July, 17 hours fasting. Alhamdulillah, we say, oh, it's tough. Always, we are not lucky here in America. It's always in July. And July here, 100 degrees in Glendale, they will ask about permit to not to fast. And and valley. And so, Allah, make it, yes, be patient. 1 month, 1 year, 2 years. Then we'll start to come in the spring. Then we'll come in winter. Then we'll come, subhanAllah, see the rahmah. It means, and the what not the difference. It is only 33 years. Why not 75 years? 33 years, usually, anyone will start his fasting in the age of 15, 14, 13, something like that. It means plus 33, 50. Khalas, that it means once you reach it 50 or 55, you fast Ramadan in all seasons. You practice Siyam in all seasons. See the rahmah, wallahi. Who can do that except Allah? وَلَبِثُوا فِي كَهْفِهِمْ 300 سِنِينَ وَازْدَادُوا 9 قُلِ اللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِعِدَّتِهِمْ وَازْدَادُوا 9 قُلِ اللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا لَبِثُوا قُلِ اللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا لَبِثُوا. Now, in the number of them, Allah says, سيقولون. But about the time they slept, Allah says, no one will give you answer. No one can give you answer except Allah. قل الله, only Allah knows that. Even themselves, the people of cave themselves, if you ask them how many years you slept, they don't. What about if you ask someone else? Themselves, they don't know. No one knows about that. So Allah, قل الله أعلم بما لبثوا. له غيب السماوات والأرض. له غيب السماوات والأرض. Unseen in the heaven and the earth, it is clear for him. له غيب السماوات والأرض. Then there is an ayah or expression, أبصر به وأسمع. What is the meaning of أبصر به وأسمع? What's the reflection in your mind about أبصر به وأسمع? ها الله يا عم احمد
ببصر الله واسمع
لا 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 that's why I ask the question. I need you to give the wrong answer, then we'll correct it to stay with you. Yes. ابصر به واسمع يعني ما ابصره بعباده. ابصر به سبحان الله. It means not this verb is not verb order form to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. No. I said, أبصر به. يعني ما أبصره بعباده. يعني there is nothing hidden from his creation in the sight of Allah. Allah knows everything. Allah sees everything. سميع بصير. بصير, it means nothing he cannot see. Nothing you can hide from him. أبصر به. فلان, we said about ولله المثل الأعلى. Someone, we said, okay, let us go and see the moon. Did you see the moon, Elias? No. Did you see the moon, Muhammad? No. Did you see the moon, Hamdi? No. Haqqi Muhammad? No. Then, we'll see. Then, we said, Siddiq, did you see the moon? Yes, it's there. Oh, we'll say what? Absaruna Siddiq. We'll say, the most sharp in his eyes, صديق. ولله المثل الأعلى. Just give that to let you understand. أبصر. أبصر به. الله طب ما أبصره بعباده. تعرف تخبي عليه حاجة؟ Can you hide anything from Allah? خلاص. Then, something existing. وأسمع. وما أعظم سمعه لا يخفى عليه صوت دبيب النملة السوداء في الصخرة الصماء في الليلة الظلماء. You cannot hide any, there is no voice. Any, يعني سبحان الله. One of the scholar is my friend, and he's now in America, but he's old now, very old. And he was preparing master degree from the Quran, and I told him what is the topic of the master degree, and he said the topic is المشاهد المسموعة. المشاهد المرئية بقى، مسألة المسموعة، المشاهد المسموعة، المشاهد. So it means what المشاهد in English؟ لا سينز ديت بلدي شوي، عاوزين حاجة جواد. You agree with that؟ المشاهد، المشاهد it means you can say seeing objectives, something you see, that's مشاهد. But he said المسموعة you can hear. And he said Allah تبارك وتعالى when he took in the Quran he took about some مشاهد, some actions happen but you cannot see but you can hear. Like what? Like what? ربنا سبحانه وتعالى بيقول ايه؟ إذ يتخافتون بينهم. يتخافتون. What يتخافتون؟ What the meaning of يتخافتون؟ They walk without noise. When Allah تبارك وتعالى talk about in سورة القلم, when Allah talk about the people of القرية in Yemen and they decide to go hiddenly and secretly to harvest all the garden. واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إنا بلوناهم كما بلونا أصحاب القرية إذ أقسموا ليصرمنها مصبحين ولا يستثنون فطاف عليها طائف من ربك وهم نائمون فأصبحت كالصريم فتنادوا مصبحين أن يغدوا على حرثكم إن كنتم صارمين فانطلقوا وهم مش حد يسمع. Let us go to the garden but no noise, no noise, no one can, don't wake up the poor people in the city, otherwise they will follow us there. So مشاهد مسموعة. Allah says here أبصر به. Allah watching everything. Then وأسمع, it means Allah hearing any movement even if you don't recognize. Like the mosquito, they have noise, yes, but you cannot hear them until you can't hear the mosquito until after hurting you. After hitting you, then you will hear the music. Yes. Pain and you will find it already. So, أبصر به وأسمع ما لهم من دونه من ولي. سبحان الله. Who's taking care of the people of Kiev? Who's taking care of them? Why not taking care of us? Why we don't think that he's taking care of us? Why we think that everything in our hand? Nothing in our hand. Nothing, everything in the hand of Allah. But Allah will reward us for following the means. For doing our part, Allah will reward us. But the result up to him. Up to him. ما لهم من دونه من ولي ولا يشرك في حكمه أحدا. Do you think that Allah, when he decided to keep them 300 years in the cave, Allah consulted with someone? Allah consulted with someone? 300 or 400 or 200? No. Even some scholars, they said, why 300? That's another issue, but not today. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, وَاتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ كِتَابِ رَبِّ. Your treasure of knowledge is the Quran. Your treasure is the Quran. واتلو. واتلو. اتلو. Why? What is the meaning of تلاوة? يتلوه. تتلى عليه آياتنا. What is the root of this verb? What's the root of the verb? تلا. تلا. What is تلا? If we said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the Salah, he said, لِيَلِيَنِي مِنْكُمْ أُولُو الْأَحْلَامِ وَالنُّهَى. Come after. That's تلاوة. تلاوة. واتلو. It means don't keep in your life, read in the Salah قل هو الله أحد أن تقول أعوذ برب الناس. Don't keep that in your salah and that's it. The salah is valid? Yes, it's valid. It's the best? No. No. I want to read, alhamdulillah, my father and my family, they said, they told me read Surah Yasin, her secret. And only Surah Yasin? In your life, just read Surah Yasin, that's it? Surah Al-Mulk before sleep, that's it? What about the remaining of the Quran? Utlu. And Allah says here, Utlu ma uhiya ilayka. Recite all the Quran. Don't recite part. You can't recite part and ignore the remaining of the Quran and say, Alhamdulillah, I read. Qul huwa Allahu ahad 1,000 times. No, don't read it once. But don't stay with one surah all of your life. That's color of talking about khushu'ah. They said when you change the surah you recite in the salah, that would help you for khushu'ah. Do you think that when you hear the Quran here, either in Isha or Fajr or Taraweeh, the entire Quran, similar like reciting every day, قل هو الله أحد, قل أعوذ رب الفلق, that we can read it in Taraweeh also every night. Sheikh Hamdi will read 4 times إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح عند 4 ركعة, and Sheikh Muhammad al-Katib قل أعوذ رب الفلق 4 times and السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. You will feel good. Something is missing. It doesn't mean قل هو الله أحد is not valuable. Each verse in the Quran valuable, but this Quran revealed to be recited. أتلو. Allah based on his rahmah he ordered us to recite the Quran, but he did not order us to memorize the Quran. No verse in the Quran said you have to memorize the Quran. No. Allah knows we are different. Some people their capacity it is hard to memorize, but some people Allah gave them this ni'mah. It is ni'mah from Allah. But if you want to do it, if you have a plate you want to put honey, clean it first. Clean it first. If you do not clean it, the honey doesn't come and it will be not honey. If you want to memorize the Quran, clean the heart first. You will find yourself focused, able to memorize. Otherwise, not. Not. That's the Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah, just he used to go. Imam Shafi'i, when he was kid, go to his teacher, Waqi' ibn al-Jarrah, teach me. Imam Shafi'i, very smart. When he looked to one page, memorized. Read it one time, ma'a salam, khalas. Then one day he came, no, one time is not enough. I did not memorize perfectly. I have to read one more. Then he complained, I need to read it 2-3 times to memorize it. What happened? It was one time before. Oh, my teacher. His teacher is not any teacher. And he told him, what you have done? He's a young man. Young man, younger than Ilyas. And he told him, what you done in today? He said, done what? He said, what you committed today? He said, in my way to the masjid, I watched heel, just heel, of a lady walking in the street. They are not American, all covered, except it's just she forgot to wear socks, or there is no socks at that time. He saw the heel, only her heel. Heel. So then I looked. Then I repeated the look. Then what? Then when I came to read, I can't memorize like yesterday. Because one look, one more over permit. Waqi' ibn al-Jarrah قال له, his teacher told him, when he said, that's because of your sin. You missed the ability to memorize. Then Shafi'i, he did not hide this story. He want to teach us. And he make poetry. He's sha'ir. قال شكوت إلى وكيع سوء حفظي فأرشدني إلى ترك المعاصي وأخبرني بأن العلم نور ونور الله لا يهدى لعاصي. I complained to my teacher that I am not able to memorize it. He said, stay away from sins. Otherwise, you will lose ilm. Ilm will go, will leave you. Doesn't come in the dirty plate. So, أُتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ كِتَابِ رَبِّكَ أُتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ read. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْحَالَّ الْمُرْتَحِلِ Start from the beginning of the Quran, الفاتحة, and every day, whatever page you can recite until you reach الناس, then come back to الفاتحة, then go back to ختمة. Do like that. That's تلاوة. That's التلاوة. There is تلاوة and ترتيل. تلاوة to follow until you come to the end of the Quran. Imagine Zayd ibn Thabit, we talk about him few nights ago after Fajr. Zayd ibn Thabit went to the Prophet Muhammad and he said, I reviewed entire Quran on Prophet Muhammad before his death. Imagine he listened to Zayd ibn Thabit reciting the entire Quran. So, من كتاب ربك واتلو ما أوحي إليك. Number one, أوحي is not by you, by Allah. Came from Allah, revealed by Allah. من كتاب, that's the only, if you said الكتاب, that's Al-Quran. If you said كتاب, you have to add another word. If you said كتاب, you can't say, maybe كتاب سليمان, to بلقيس, that's a كتاب. اذهب بكتابي هذا, فألقي إليه. But if we said كتاب, you have to add. If you talk about Al-Quran, if you said Al-Kitab, enough. If you said Kitab, no, it's not enough. Add. Kitabi Rabbik. Rabbik. That's the book of Allah. La mubaddila li kalimatih. Once the Quran revealed on the earth, till the day of Qiyamah, will stay as is. La mubaddila li kalimatih. Wa lan tajida min dunihi multahada. And without Allah, you cannot find any protection except by Allah. وَلَنْ تَجْدَ مِنْ دُونِهِ مُلْتَحَدًا. Then the verse will try our best to stop by this verse. وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ وَكَانَ أَمْرُهُ فُرُطًا. Verse number 28. Then there is some people, very humble people. Like the scholar they named them, Bilal ibn Rabah, Suhaib, and Khabbab ibn al-Arat, we talk about him, Khabbab. And those humble people, they used to come and they sit down with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, enjoy to listen to the Quran from the mouth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the tafsir and the soap by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the leaders of Mecca, they said, one of them, he came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, "Ama yu'dhika natanu ha'ula?" Khabbab, he has dirty clothes. What he has, even piece of the skin of goats or so, and he put it, and it's, the smell is not that good. No, yani France perfume, like now. So he came and said, then he said, how you, Muhammad, do you need us to sit down with you and join those people? Wallahi, we can. If we are the head of the people, we are the head of the tribes. If we accepted Islam, all the people, they will follow us. Give us time. Why you waste your time with those people? Then Prophet Muhammad Sallam, he started to think about maybe, not because he disliked those, but he wished more people to come to Islam. And he said, maybe I can give them a time separately. Then Allah revealed this verse. He said, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ. Whatever the smell is, whatever the heart's clean. Some people, they're closed from outside. Fancy clothes. The suit from, not Macy's, maybe something bigger than Macy's, I don't know. What is else? I don't know. Yani very expensive. سانتا مونيكا. So but subhanallah, wallahi, is not only the heart is dirty. No. Even their private part is dirty. Fancy suits from outside, when they use bathroom, they don't wash, clean their private parts. What about the heart? Same, like private parts. So Allah says, wasbir nafsaka ma'a alladhina yad'una rabbahum bilghadati wal'ashi yuriduna wajha. Stay with those. They ask Allah morning and evening to forgive them, and they try their best to please Allah tabarak ta'ala, and Allah ordering you to spend more time with those people. They are better than the leaders. ولا تعد عيناك عنهم. Don't ignore them even by your eyes only. If you are giving a lecture, giving a khutbah, wallahi that's the sunnah. يعني may Allah forgive us for some shortcoming. But even give lecture also, look to everyone. عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه is saying, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, if he's giving khutbah or lecture or درس, he used to look everyone, look to everyone, until everyone expected that maybe he's the main one in this group. And he said one day, he was looking and he looked to me. I said, oh, Prophet Muhammad, he focused me. Maybe I am the most beloved one to him. And he said, Amr ibn al-As, very smart, very smart. Then he said, maybe let me get credit today. And ask, Prophet, I have a question. Because he looked to him and he expected, but Prophet Muhammad was looking to everyone. And he said, oh, Prophet Muhammad, who's the most beloved companion to you? Then he told him, Aisha. Aisha, what are, we are men here in the masjid. So he said, oh, Prophet Muhammad, from the men. He wished to say Amr. No, he said, her father, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Then Amr, he said, well, I wish that I did not ask him. It was much better. So Allah says, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا لِسَانَهُ أُذُنَهُ قَلْبَهُ. هي الغفلة فين؟ في القلب. من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا. question عن ذكرنا. what ذكرنا يا محمد؟ what ذكرنا؟ يسبح. ها ذكرنا, ها ذكرنا, ذكرنا, ذات ذكرنا. من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا. الذكر is the Quran. الذكر is the Quran. Anything after that will come after the Quran. إنا نحن نزلنا الذكر وإنا له لحافظون. That's the الذكر. So some people they said, I want read the word of the Quran today. He said, I am busy with تسبيح. تسبيح is good, but the Quran is better. Quran is better. Read the Quran. I read one juz of Quran, but I don't have enough time to say Subhanallah walhamdulillah. No problem. Allah will give you reward because you were busy with the Quran. ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه. طب والقلب يعمل إيه؟ القلب هيقرأ؟ لا, القلب يتدبر. القلب يتدبر. When you read the Quran, think deeply in the meaning. That's why we have tafsir, especially in country like this. Many non-Arabic speakers, and they read Quran. Some of them memorize the Quran. Some Pakistani brothers and Afghanians memorize the entire Quran. And they may be better than us in memorization, but they don't know the meaning. Because the Quran originally Arabic. So we need to know the meaning. وَلَا تُطْعِ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ وَكَانَ أَمْرُهُ فُرُطًا. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to accept from all of us and help all of us to love one another for the sake of Allah and gather all of us in the Jannah. Jazakum Allah khair. Taqabba Allah minna wa minkum. 28, remember. Yes. Ask a question, yeah.
I was in Syria in Damascus, in Hamas. I went to a masjid, and there was a grave in the center, two graves. One is like a young man, and one is like a, and they say it's a poet, prophet. And outside there's like a...
They said prophet?
Yeah.
Where you said where?
Damascus, Hamas.
Oh, Hams. What is the name of the masjid?
But outside the masjid, the yard, there's a truck, very big, like with a timber.
Mm.
And a big tire, like you can, even 50 of us can push it. He said that prophet used to push it.
Oh. Sallu ala nabas. I'll give you short answer. I did not go to Hims. But short answer.